What's up, everybody? It's your boy Caleb P. Jordan, and y'all already know it. And today we are back with another video, and I have my special guest with me, Pastor B. We weren't trying to do another back-to-back video with Pastor B, but the reason why we're doing this is because there is no sports going on, so we're gonna add more fun debates with it. Hopefully, many more comes while we're doing this during our quarantine, y'all. Quarantine. So, I hope y'all paying attention. I hope y'all doing okay while the coronavirus going on.
Corona
ain't had nobody safe.
Hopefully, your family members are being safe. I hope everybody's being safe. Wash your hands, clean your hands, wash your face, stay out of people's face, and don't touch nobody. But anyway, so we will be back. See, sweetie, wait. But we will be back. We're gonna come back with our topic after the intro. So we're back at it. It's me and Pastor B, and today for our assignment we were going to do a basically like not a fantasy football, but if you have some young kids, Madden Ultimate Team, you're gonna pick your players on whatever team you want, and I'm gonna pick my players on the team. Basically, we're doing like an all-time NFL. We're doing NFL this week, and we're gonna do all-time. We'll do college next week, and we're doing NFL this week. We'll do all-time. And, hopefully we're going to start off. And I want Pastor B, you're going to go first because you are the guest. So go ahead and explain of your all-time.
Yeah, well, I want to, everybody on Caleb P. Jordan show is my team. Well, hello, everyone. What I'm going to do is, because football is a team sport, and it's not about one individual player that makes the team. It's about team sports. It's about teams coming, each player coming together with their great tools and gifts, where they come together and reach out and take that one goal, meet the team's objectives. So anyways, what I'm going to do is I'm going to just go pick a team. I'm not going to do individual players and build a team, because they have been great, well, good football teams in the NFL, like 2000 Redskins. They had a lot of Pro Bowlers on that team, and they didn't do anything that year. So anyway, what I'm going to go is my top defensive team. It was a toss-up between the 85 Bears, but I got to go with the 2000 Baltimore Ravens, because that lineup with Ray Lewis, Tony Siragusa, you had Peter Bowler, you had Jimmy Sharper as a defensive, as a linebackers. Then you had Chris McCallister, you had my main man, hard-hitting Rod Woodson in a safety position. I mean, you just had a great team. And also by having Marvin Lewis as a defensive coordinator, on the defensive coordinator, that job, got him to the, have one of the longest 10 years of head coaching football with the Bengals. But also, this is the one reason why. Well, two reasons why. Brian Billick, he was the head coach. He's an offensive-minded head coach. You remember when for the Vikings, and when running Grant Cunningham and Chris Carter and Randy Moss's rookie year, he was the offensive coordinator. So you take an offensive coordinator, offensive-minded guy, put him on as a head coach, and his defense wins that whole, just dominated the whole NFL that year. Then you take Trent Dilfer, who's an underrated quarterback, and you just say, hey, just don't turn the ball over. So that's why I'm picking the 2000 Baltimore Ravens as my all-time defensive team. And also what they did to what's his name, the running back for the Eddie George. He was a great running back. I'll say great. Dude was a great running back until they met up with Ray Lewis in that 2000 season in that AFC playoff game and divisional playoff game, and he was never the same ever since, because let it be known, they were representing the AFC in the Super Bowl when they previous year when they lost lost to St. Louis. So and that was a good Tennessee team. But what they did went to Eddie George. They took his heart out. That's my pick. Thanks.
My offense will clearly obliterate you. Well, it clearly obliterates your defense, okay? Yes, you have Ray Lewis. Yes, you have all the other guys. The Italian dude, Ferragoso, whatever.
Bro, what are you talking about, man?
Ferragoso, man. Saragusa,
oh,
man.
Oh, Saragusa.
You know what? Before I start, this is before you bad go, hey, KJ. Just let it be known, everyone. Eddie George was a Heisman Trophy winner. He had a great.
So was Robert Griffin III.
Hold up. But then this dude.
So was Mark.
This dude was on Dr. Pepper commercials.
So was
Baker
Mayfield.
That's the only time you heard of him.
And what are they doing now? And what are they doing now? Nothing.
Ravens did to this guy.
No.
But anyway, go ahead. Go with your team.
So, as Caleb P. Jordan, I decided to have, because I am the head coach. This is my defense. You know, I am Coach O. This is right here. Is Clay Helton.
Team 14 offenses look great. A la Deagle. As SC sends it away, Smith Marset inside the five. Hops through the hole. Watch out. He can fly. Smith Marset down the sideline. See you later. Touchdown Hawkeyes. 98 yards.
Okay. So if you know Clay Helton,
ever since I was young, they said I won't be nothing. Now they always say congratulations. Worked so hard, forgot how to vacation. They ain't never had the dedication. People hating, say we changing. Look, we made it. Yeah, we made it.
Alright, so Cardinals
gonna
be better than this. But also, as my quarterback, I will have Patrick Mahomes. Dual threat quarterback, okay, knows how to run the ball, knows how to throw the ball, great offensive player of mine. My fullback, Kyle Juszczyk, okay?
All around me are familiar faces, worn out.
He won a Super Bowl with the Ravens, the team that you were talking about, and that's another 2000, but still, you have to understand the fullback knows how to run the ball, knows how to catch the ball, everything. He's not your ordinary fullback.
They don't have fullbacks when they have all-time teams. They have two running backs. You pick a fullback for your all-time team? Come on, man.
Why would I pick two running backs?
Because that's what they
Barry
do
Sanders?
For all time.
You would have Barry Sanders and Jim Brown on the same team? Why?
Yeah,
one is not going to play the other. Okay. No. Why would I have Barry Sanders at fullback when I can get a nice, great fullback who already is playing, Kyle Juszczyk? All right. Then, my running backs, if you got to argue me, I'm still defense. You know what I'm saying? I did my study. I did my research. I got my facts.
You have a fullback, an eye formation, and you have a running back who doesn't drop back.
How you know what my running back is?
No, I mean offense. Your quarterback doesn't drop back. He operates out the shotgun. How you going to have a fullback in a shotgun spread offense?
Because my spread offense, I can have my fullback as like another tight end after my other tight end I'm going to name. Or while we having a spread, my tight end can run like the short passing and stuff like that. I got this. I'm Caleb P. Jordan. I got this. I got my playbook ready, okay? My running back, I have Jim Brown. This man brought, this is why Cleveland is still relevant these days. Yes, because of Jim Brown. Jim Brown. That's the only reason why. Because of Jim Brown. If it wasn't for Jim Brown,
moved the team in the middle of the night saying at 10 o'clock, I'm not moving the team. And at 3 o'clock in the morning, there's 18-wheelers packing up the facility in Cleveland and they're heading to Baltimore. What are you talking about, Jim Brown?
Jim Brown. Listen, listen, ladies and gentlemen. He doesn't watch it, but I do. The NFL Network, you know, they have these little things. Football Life. And Jim Brown, Rock the Dane, Cleveland Glory Days. Cleveland Glory Days. That was a title of that episode. Cleveland Glory. glory.
In the 60s, they couldn't win it in the 80s with Bernie Kosar and Eric Metcalf,
Cleveland
man.
Cleveland glory. That's when you last time heard about the Cleveland Browns, okay? Cleveland at all wouldn't be relevant if it wasn't for the Cavs when LeBron was there. They wouldn't be relevant now if it wasn't for Francisco Lindor, which he doesn't know. Francisco Lindor plays for the Indians.
I'm talking about when Jim Tomey and all those Lofton, all these great baseball teams. Like, come on, man. You know your history.
Now these days, the Cleveland would not be relevant if it wasn't for the Indians. Okay? Yes. All right. I am picking DeAndre Hopkins as my wide receiver. I got two wide receivers. I have DeAndre Hopkins and I have Randy Moss, okay? You can't argue with that. And if you want to argue with that, I got my facts with me. My tight end. I have my boy Shannon Sharp. And I forgot to do the other tight end. It was him and somebody else. Played with the Falcons.
I wouldn't know anything about Shannon Sharp unless he was on that show with Skip.
Yes, I wouldn't know.
Who watched Fox Sports 1 anyway?
I don't. I watch ESPN, but I
and
watch
Fox Sports. When I came in here, Shannon Sharp. You had him. You probably thought that you were probably picking Sterling Sharp, but you didn't know that, honey. His brother.
Sterling I didn't Sharp. Know who Shannon Sharp was.
Oh, Sterling. I'm talking Sterling Sharp boys. You didn't even know you had a brother, man.
Okay, but still.
Come on, man.
But still, you gotta think about it though. Let me tell you something. When you have Shannon Sharp. Let me tell you something about Fox. Tony Gonzalez. Yeah, that's who it was gonna be. But
that's your team, you know what I mean?
But that's not my team.
Oh no, he's on your top team, your all time ultimate team.
No, he wasn't. I said it was gonna be him or Shannon Sharp, but I chose Shannon Sharp.
So you picked you forgot his name.
You gotta think about somebody. You gotta think about like me. I can't be sitting there watching ESPN all day. I never learn nothing.
Nobody's watching ESPN all day. COVID going on because they're not doing
anything. But listen. You gotta think about. You got Fox. You got CBS. You gotta learn more about more people, not just ESPN. That's the only reason why. But yes, my tight end. I have Shannon Sharp. My left tackle. I have Joe Thomas. My left guard. I have David DeCastro. My center. I have Travis Frederick. My right guard, I have Marshall Yanda. And my right tackle, I have Trent Williams. So, Father, this is the time to debate me. We know you're going to be wrong. Okay. So, it's okay. Debate me at any time. Right. I got my facts with me. All so, right. You know what? Well, you can go ahead and debate me.
Well, first of all, I don't know what type of...
This is the offense I run.
What type of offense are you run? You're picking players that are, like, okay, your quarterback is maximizing in a running heavy in a pass heavy offense. Your running backs are in a run heavy offense. You have a quarterback. I mean, it's like I don't know what plays you're gonna do, man.
I'm Philip Jordan.
You find a play? All right. So your O line, your tight ends, it's kind of like okay, you picked out tight ends that I mean, like Shannon Sharp can block and
catch. Yeah, and catch. I need a catch tight end.
But you need to spread it.
I need that Travis Kelce tight end.
You need to spread the ball. But then
I can finesse you. You don't know what I'm gonna run. I'm gonna finesse you. I got threats out here. I'm gonna finesse you. I'm gonna do the Caleb P. Jordan special.
You think it's Tecmo Bowl, man? I don't know what type of offense you're gonna run. This deep, you know what? My defense, I mean, they just stopped everybody who came through them. I have you up. This is my ultimate team. And he was like, okay, sir, who you have me playing with? Who's my quarterback? What? Who's my left tackle? What? Who's my right? What? He would look at you and like, what are you doing, young man? How you have me on the same team with, I don't even know half the people you name. He probably would say, okay, well I'll take Shannon Sharp and Joe Thomas because, you know, Cleveland or whatever. But I don't know, man.
I did my studying. That's why I put them together. I had different people to to add. I could have switched them out, but I was like, you know what? This will fit in my offense, and that's why I picked him.
How you gonna take? What was your other tight end?
I was like Tony Gonzalez.
No. What's the other one?
I only have one tight end.
Cool. I thought you picked another tight. I thought you were gonna do something else. But anyway, come on. You got a fullback. That's another thing. You have an awesome team. You have a fullback on your ultimate team.
Yes.
You don't have to do that. You can add another running back to it. But okay. All right. Who do you have then?
All right. I'm gonna do my defense. So my defense, like my offense, is goated. Alright, I have two basic linebackers playing in my defensive end. I have Von Miller. I have Khalil Mack as my two defensive ends. They will embarrass your offense. They will tear your offense up. They will go change your TV provider, sit in your lazy boy, and then...
Sounds familiar. Taking my stuff, what I say, what the Baltimore Ravens did to Eddie George, how they, you know, weak of the knees, made my man, weak in, and if you know who Eddie George, you know about Eddie George, you know, his wife's married to one of the NSWB, the one of the singers, and what they did to him, he was never the same player. I mean, it's like Ray Lewis and those guys from the Ravens went to his house, change his cable provider, grab his remote.
I just said that.
Yeah, but bro, you take what I said a couple times.
He did say that. We were having a pre-debate.
They would not beat you on the field. They'll beat you off the field. So that's what the Baltimore Ravens did. But go ahead.
All right, so Von Miller and Khalil Mack. All right, the Mack attack. You know what I'm saying? So, then my defensive line, I understand it to be rare. I have Nick Bosa, because Nick Bosa, they come from a not good 49ers to a now a great 49ers. And that defense, the number one defense in America, okay? You got to understand is that when you have 32 solo tackles, 9 sacks, 1 forced fumble, and 1 interception, I'll take you, my brother, and you young, okay? So you got to understand, man, Nick Bosa is the man. And my other defensive line, I have Von Miller I got two defensive line and two DE. I'm running a 4-3.
Yeah, you can only have four defensive linemen on the line.
I'm Caleb P. Jordan, man.
First of all, you messed up. You got two linebacker / ends that rush because you put on the type of defense you're running. Then you have a defensive end and you put him to the defensive line, so you can switch to defense tackle. You run a 4-3. What's your other? That's how you got confused, America.
No,
you had 18 dudes on the defensive line.
No, I did not.
You know,
listen, I have Von Miller as my defensive end. I have Khalil Mack as my defensive end. Nick Bosa is my defensive line, and Lawrence Taylor is my defensive line.
Man, Lawrence Taylor is. That dude can't play a D line.
Defensive tackle.
On the end, D tackle.
Okay, you know what?
That's light, dude. Okay.
Lawrence Taylor, you're going to obey me today, and I'm going to tell you, I'm going to put you in the defensive line.
Man,
okay?
You don't know who Lawrence Taylor is.
My linebacker.
My linebacker.
I'm going to bring a great safety to my linebacker because he plays a strong safety. So, you know, a strong safety,
No, you don't.
A strong safety is like a linebacker, and a free safety is like an extra cornerback. So I'm gonna bring this great strong safety to a linebacker,
and the name goes by
Brian Dawkins.
What?
Okay?
Oh my goodness.
Brian Dawkins. Okay. Then my other linebacker, I'm running with Ray Lewis. Okay. And then I have another linebacker because I'm running a 4-3. So I'm running with Brian Urlacher.
That's two middle linebackers.
I'm rearranging them.
One could be the weak side, one be strong.
Yes, sir.
That's why I'm going to attack.
They not.
I will.
They not.
Brian, I don't know about these linebackers, man. You need to learn how to cover.
No, I don't know about that.
So
then my strong safety, I'm going with my favorite NFL player in the NFL, and that's Jamal Adams. Shout out to my boy, Jamal Adams. He's my strong safety. And then, God rest his soul, he was supposed to be 37 last Wednesday. Sean Taylor, he's going to be my free safety, knows how to block. 41 pass deflections in his career, and he's a free safety. Not a corner, a free safety. So that's right there good. So we know that's Lawrence, Taylor, Khalil Mack, Brian Dawkins, Ray Lewis, Jamal Adams, Sean Taylor, Deion Sanders, and Charles Woodson.
All right,
Oh, yeah, and Brian Urlacher. Yeah.
That's cool. He got some speed out there.
Yeah, he got some speed, you know what I'm saying? It ain't about... I was reading my book. Ladies and gentlemen, getting y'all books today, you know what I'm saying? I'm reading my... During this COVID-19, getting y'all books. I was reading, where is my book? It was right here, okay? It's a John Wooden book, one of the greatest college basketball coaches that plays. The cover is somewhere behind it. A Game Plan for Life. And I was reading a chapter of Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, his real name is Louis Alcindor. And the reason why he chose UCLA was because they weren't tall and big, their speed. And how many rings did they win? To answer my question right there, the speed made them win the game, not the toughness and other
things.
My speed's gonna win the game. So, Father, take your time to discuss why your team will lose.
Well, look, my speed, he has some speed, but I don't think they can hold up with this offense. And I'm gonna go with the 2019 Kansas City Chiefs because of the speed.
Wait a minute.
Mickey Mouse straw.
Hi, everybody.
Anyway. Kool-Aid and a Mickey Mouse straw. Come on, man. How you even have it on your show? Don't your fans know you? Mickey Mouse straw?
No, listen. It was a gift from a family member. So,
yeah, I know.
So that's right.
$20 for that straw.
Yeah.
But anyway, so what?
Stay young, kids.
So, yeah. So, what? I'm kind of losing focus here because there's a lot going on.
Why you always lying?
The little Chiefs.
No, the Chiefs. So you want my reason why I picked the Chiefs?
Go ahead, pick your reason why.
And then we're going to go in. Because, I mean, there was a lot of offensive teams out there that I picked, but I was looking at for the Chiefs. I mean, it's kind of like if you attack them with the zone, they'll beat you. If you come at them with man, they'll beat you. They'll just spread it out and they can get physical if they have to. And I think if they have to, like, spread out and go fast, they'll do that. And, you know, I mean, they can just beat you. They have a lot of speed on that team. Like, his defensive team that he picked, they have a lot of speed. I think Brian Urlacher would get exposed in the coverage. I think Brian Dawkins would get exposed in the coverage as well because you can come up and hit all day and try to stop the run.
Who did they get exposed by?
Your wide receiving core, Tariq Hill.
Tyreek Hill,
whatever the brother name is. Sorry, Tariq. T. Hill, you have a good running game. You have, I mean, you can spread out your running backs. You have Travis Kelce can hurt you. You have Sammy Watkins can hurt you. No. I didn't say that they couldn't, like, come and tackle. But coverage, people, this style of football that's played today is about coverage, about matchups. It's not about who looks good, looks pretty in uniform. It's about matchups. You expose that. I already named two people that they'll get exposed against the speed of the chain, Kansas City Chiefs. And that's it. Now, the Chiefs don't have to run the ball. Now, I don't think the team can stop the run or put pressure on the quarterback. But, no. All I give you one quarter that your team, your defense can handle.
One quarter.
And that's it. They get exposed.
We did a pre-show the other day, and I heard you say that the wide receivers were decoys.
Yeah, you have to play that decoy. Wide receiver could be a decoy. If you look
why?
At because that's
what you just
that's,
said.
I just said
fly routes.
Well, no, I'm saying like you.
I am very confused right now
because you don't. You play checkers and I play check, you know, that's
I play checkers. I beat you. How many times I beat you?
Anyway,
I don't know. How many times I beat you?
Yeah, we ain't talking about chess. I'm at work and you are getting practice, but I ain't go there.
What?
Anyway, you asked me a question and I'm trying to tell you, then you're like,
I answered it for you.
No, you didn't. No, you didn't.
Because that doesn't make any sense. How are they equal?
Okay, because it's about matchup.
Okay.
So, case in point. If you call certain plays, like, okay, Travis Kelce, you can put Travis Kelce and line up with Sammy Watkins and Tariq Hill on the same side of the field, you can kind of have like some kind of bunch wide receiver formation to where you're heavy on one side, heavy on the other side, and you can call a play. Or maybe the defense is like, look, we're going to focus on, we really want, you want to go to Travis Kelce, but maybe Tariq can get out. Well, I say it back. The defense might want to, like, say, okay, we need to watch out for Travis Kelce. Well, you know what? Tariq can break out and go out. You can.
Yes, that's why OBJ,
like, he don't. That's why he doesn't have a lot of numbers the last couple of seasons, because he's a decoy. While Odell Beckham Jr., he's a decoy. He's going to stretch the field. The defense is going to focus on him, and that's why it's going to open up for Landry and other players to get catches. That's what football's about.
Well, listen, man, you understand it.
Your world. That's why you just. No, my man. Team, Kool-Aid.
This is it. My team.
And a straw from Mickey Mouse straw.
Listen,
anyway.
My team would demolish your team, and that's the end of the conversation.
Why?
Give
me a reason why your team would demolish my team.
Because, you know why?
Why?
Caleb B. Jordan.
Man, you're not even going to be on the field anyway.
So, I want y'all, this is the time for y'all to go in your comment section. And y'all go ahead. I found out how to disable it, so now y'all free to comment section. Go in the comment section and figure out who's gonna who you think will win, Pastor B or Caleb P. Follow me on Twitter, where you can get out debates. You debate with me anytime you want, and just like that. So I hope you have a blessed day. I hope you be safe from the coronavirus, and y'all stay home. And y'all make the smart move. It's the Caleb P. Jordan Show, and y'all already know.